Hello everyone, my name is Clément Gignac, Senior VP and Chief Economist for IA Financial Group. So today is March 19, this is Federal Budget Day, but over the next 5-7 minutes I will not talk about the federal budget since it will be released only later on today, but more summarize in fact the webinar that we have just recorded for our clients and our financial advisor. So before sharing my view for 2019 or 2020, why not make a quick postmortem of what we have seen since our latest Facebook? So keep in mind that last year was a painful year, 2019, particularly December. It was the worst December month ever seen on Wall Street since the 30s. So it was significant. At that time, some people mentioned that maybe we'll go to recession and so on. So if you remember my latest Facebook that we have recorded in early January, we have mentioned that we do not see any recession coming. And if we are right with our view that we have no recession, history told us that the market will recover quickly the losses that we have experienced. Be honest, the recovery is even faster and quicker than what I thought at that time. So basically, the market has already recovered close to 90% of the losses that we have experienced fourth quarter. So this is a lesson here. It's important when you invest in the stock market in equities to have a long-term view, not panic and take with a grain of salt all the headline that we have. But having said that, it was a good reason why the market has dropped in the fourth quarter. We talk about trade tension, China, US, we talk about interest rate increase. But since then, and that explains why the market has rebounded so nicely, we have seen relief on interest rate front. We no longer talk about interest rate increase, and relief on the trade tension, because now Mr. Trump seems more ready to negotiate with China about the trade deal. So this is a positive development. What about the economy? So make no mistake, we'll see some deceleration. In fact, on U.S. economy, the last year was fueled by the tax cut and so on. So this year we talk about some deceleration of the U.S. economy, but we do not see any recession anytime soon. As a matter of fact, I mentioned quite often that business cycle never die of old age. So we need something. So with interest rates so low, close to zero, adjust for inflation. So this is not enough to in fact stop the economic growth. And so in fact, if you check, the fundamentals are quite good. If you check all the leading indicators on our dashboard, they are on the green. So we are confident about a prolonged economic expansion. In addition, if you check overseas, for example, on China, because China explains 1/3 of the global economic growth, we see the Chinese government now shift 180 degrees and now try to stimulate the economy, go with tax cut and so on. So our comfort zone has increased as well regarding that. So the stock market is an anticipation market. So don't be confused by the fact that the economy as we speak continue to decelerate, but the market recovered the losses because the market look ahead and see that with the decision of Chinese government to stimulate the economy, with the Federal Reserve decision to put interest rate on the back burner. So this is something positive and the expansion will continue, and that helped the equity market. Talking about Canada quickly, I mentioned earlier that I could not comment the federal budget since we record this Facebook before the release of the document, but we are optimistic about a prolonged expansion in Canada too. Contrary to US, the Canadian economy is not grow as fast as US because we have not used too much stimulus. So we will see after the federal budget, but we are confident about the fact that we have a prolonged expansion in Canada too. Keep in mind the Canadian labor is very resilient, led by immigration. We have a strong immigration that contributes to the wealth creation overnight. On interest rate fund, the same thing on Bank of Canada. We have no significant inflationary pressure. So that's the reason interest rate is on hold, and the central bank would be passionate about any interest rate increase. So this is a good news. Talking about the stock market, I explained earlier that we have recovery. So what we'll do from now on? So in fact, if you make the postmortem the last 6 months, the market, if you go with the S&P 500, US stock market barometer, in fact, in last September, they trade at 16.5 times forward earnings. They dropped to 13.5, 14 times forward earnings in December. And now we are back to 16.5 times for earnings. From now on, the upside on the stock market US will be determined by, in fact, earnings growth. On that front, we see, unfortunately, some headwind. So last year, earnings have grown by 25% in the US side, and this year, we think it would be flat growth. So no growth at all on earnings. So if we have no growth at all on earnings, the upside of US stock market from now on is very limited. So that's the reason we encourage people to take some profits and redeploy their exposure in equities more to Canadian equities, overseas or emerging, because we think that the upside of earnings will be more significant. In Canada, in fact, it's still a huge discount compared to US, so that's the reason we see some upside. The same thing, in fact, on overseas market and on emerging. Do not forget an emerging market. Emerging market represent only 13% of global capitalization on stock market, but they explain 60% of the economic growth. So that's the reason in the funds I manage for IA, particularly the global funds, we have increased, in fact, to 15%, 16% the exposure on equity. So this is a wrap-up because I will lose my voice, and we encourage you to talk with your financial planner. Have a good day.